Hi dear students, a warm welcome to the English session. In today's session, let me explain one of the most interesting prose, that is The Tiger King, from supplementary reader of class 12. The Tiger King is written by Ramaswamy Krishnamurthy. He is better known by his pet name Kalki. He was an Indian writer, poet, journalist and critic. Moreover, Indian independent activist. Before proceeding to the prose, The Tiger King, I would like to develop a question based on your previous knowledge. What is the general attitude towards wild animal by human being? Of course, people feel fear on wild animal because of their ferociousness and tendency to harm human beings. But some people around us, they violate them by caging, by hunting. And also, we could see some people, they protect them. Though they know that they are the endangered species, so they create awareness and they try to protect them. Let me give you a brief introduction to the lesson, The Tiger King. The Tiger King is a story about the great Maharaja of Pratibhanandapuram, was also known as the Tiger King. It was predicted that he would become a great warrior and he would become the champion of champions. And also, astrologer predicted that his death would come from the tiger. In order to prove the prophecies of the astrologer wrong, the great king of Pratibhanandapuram, he had killed 99 tigers mercilessly, but the 100th one, which is supposed to be cause for the king's death, escaped from the king's bullet. And finally, the king was killed by an inanimate tiger which made of wood. Hence, astrologer's prediction proved to be true. Now, let us discuss the chapter paragraph-wise. In the first paragraph, writer who introduces the main character of the prose, the Tiger King, who is none other than the king of Pratibhanandapuram. He is a hero. He is considered as a hero because of his bravery, valorness, warlike attitude. Even when he was ruling his kingdom, he always desired to conquer other kingdom as well as to extend his empire. Such a king, he assumed numerous titles in order to glorify his name in the history. He assumed different titles. Some of the titles I would like to mention here: MAD, ACTC, CRCK, Jamedar General, Kiledar Major, Satavyagra Samhari. These are the titles assumed by the king of Pratibhanandapuram just to appreciate himself and to show the world how he was when he was ruling. But here the problem, to sum up all the titles in one name, he was called as the Tiger King. And I already pronounced some of the acronyms like MAD, CRCK, ACTC. Generally, these acronyms do not have any full form. Just for his pride, he used that titles. Yes, in our history, we already studied that great ruler's history, like Pulakeshi II, who conquered entire South India. After conquering South India, he assumed the title as Dakshinapateshwara Maharajadiraja. Maharajadiraja means king of great kings. Such titles and such rulers we have heard in our history. And now let us go to the next paragraph, what the writer reveals here. And the writer who gives promises us that he will not go back from his promise, what he wanted to tell about the Tiger King. Even if he comes under the threat of Stuka bomber aircraft. He would not worry to convey the story of Tiger King. Have you heard about Stuka bomber? Stuka bomber is a German bomber aircraft that was mainly used during the Second World War. It played a major role in order to defeat the enemy countries in the Second World War. Of course, you all know that Second World War, it was started in the year 1939 and ended in the year 1945 with the establishment of UNO in order to bring peace among the nation. Well, dear students, here writer tells us that if he came under the attack of Stuka bomber, he would not be worried to convey the story of the Tiger King. But he is as good interested to convey the story of the Tiger King. Further, he, before elaborating the entire story of the Tiger King, what made him to be the Tiger King, what turned him to be Tiger King, before elaborating, he wanted to tell an important thing to the reader, that those who read about the Tiger King, they would be very excited to meet such an indomitable person. But unfortunately, we cannot meet him because the king was dead and he has reached the heaven. I used here one difficult word, indomitable. Have you heard that word? No. Indomitable means undefeatable. So we have to struggle hard to beat or to defeat such a person. So we can consider here indomitable means undefeatable. The person who had killed 99 tigers when he was ruling in his kingdom. So such a person considered as here indomitable. If any person after reading this story who wanted to meet him, they will not fulfill their aspirations because that person was already dead and he has reached the above. The writer used the name as Bharata said Rama about Dasharatha. Have you heard about Ramayana? Yes, Dasharatha was one of the noble character which mentioned in the Ramayana. Bharata, he wanted to convey the death news of his father to Rama when he was in the forest life. But when he visited the forest, he did not convey the death news directly to the Rama. Instead, he conveyed like this. The king has reached abode. Abode means the final living place. That means heaven. Now, the manner in which the king was dead is very extraordinarily interesting. And the writer says that the manner one who wanted to know how and what made the king to die, that would be secret and one should understand at the end of the story. But here, the people who gathered in that kingdom, they forced the astrologer to reveal about the secret of the death of the Tiger King. And the astrologer who foretold that the baby, just a 10-day-old baby, the crown prince, who would get death as soon as possible and that would come from a strange thing. As normally, like other child, even the Tiger King also would grow. He would become such a great warrior, he would become a courageous person, he would become physically strong and he would be considered as a champion of champions. He would be like other son of other king. And by hearing that, all the people who kept quiet, but further, the astrologer was forced to revealed the secret of his death. This is a secret which should not be revealed. The astrologer who said them that the secret should not be revealed. And yet, all the people who gathered in the kingdom, they forced him to reveal about the death news of this the king. Now, the astrologer who decided to predict about the secret of his death, the time the baby born would have to die one day. That is the main thing. At the very great moment, a miracle, inexplicable things which took place, astonishing praise emerged from the lips of the 10-day-old king. He is also called as Jilani Jang Jang Bahadur. As soon as the astrologer predicted the life and future of this baby, just 10-day-old boy who uttered the words that made astonishing the people who are gathered there. Everyone who stood stunned by looking the sight of that child, and it spoke clearly, and moreover it questioned intelligently. O wise prophets, it was I who spoke. Soon, a just 10-day-old baby who just asked the astrologer about he would get death. So, he questioned the prophet to reveal about his death. The time, there were no grounds for doubt. It was the infant born just 10 days ago who had enunciated the verse so clearly. Being a small 10-day-old baby who spoke clearly, that made all the people who gathered there to get bewildered, get amazement. The chief astrologer who wanted to tell about his future, he took off his glasses because of that amazement and stunning. All those who are born will have to die one day. We don't give a prediction to know that. There would be some sense in it. If you could tell us the manner of that death, the royal infant uttered these words in his little squeaky voice. As soon as the prediction heard by this infant baby, who spoke suddenly and asked a question very interestingly to the astrologer that those who born on this earth would have to die one day. But there would be some sense if anyone could tell the manner of his death. Otherwise, the person who is got birth here and dying is, it's a natural process. It's a common fact. But there is no, or there is nothing new in it. But he would acknowledge the wisdom of the astrologer if he could tell the manner of his death. The chief astrologer placed his finger on his nose wonder. A baby, barely 10 days old, opened its lips in speech. Not only that, it also raises the intelligent questions, incredible, rather like the bulletins issued by the War Office than facts. The time when the astrologer heard the question from the 10 days old boy, he got confusion and he got tension. It was like a notice he received from the battlefield. Such an extreme thing it showed in that words we could remember here. The chief astrologer took his finger off his nose and fixed it upon the little ones. He was really bewildered. The astrologer who predicted the future of that king, he asked him that he would get to die as soon as possible, because that star, the time when he born, that star which represents the bull. As we all know that bull and tiger are each other enemies. So, he would get death from tiger. That is the main reason. Now, the boy who decided to take a challenge and who decided to, yes, kill the tiger in his life. The prince was born in the hour of the bull. The bull and the tiger are enemies. therefore death comes from the tiger, he explained. The main reason for his death, which comes from the tiger, that was nothing, yes, the time of his birth, which represents the star, symbolizes bull. Since bull and tiger are enemies each other, so he would get death from tiger. That is the thing. Yes, the reader who read this lesson, they may feel that the tiger king would be terrified by hearing the name of the tiger. But on the other hand, in contrary, the king did not get any tension, or he did not get any worry about it. Instead, he told the astrologer to shoot tigers beware in my kingdom. This account is only rumor rife in Pratibandhapuram, but with the insight we may conclude it was based on some truth. As the writer who heard this story as a rumor, but somehow it may be true. Now, after this incident, as usual, other like baby, this prince who started to learn skills of war and other weapons and all, he grown up like other children day by day, and since there was no miracle took place in his kingdom. The boy drank the milk of an English cow, was brought up by an English nanny, tutored in English by an English man. Saw nothing but English films, exactly as the crown princes of all the other Indian states did. When he came at the age of 20, the state which had been with the court of wars until then came into his hands. Like other sons of a king, he grown up. He drank the milk of white cow, he was brought under the control of English nanny, and he watched English movies, and he learned all the skills which required for a king, everything king. And when he came at the age of 20, he got the kingdom which was under the control of court wars. He crowned to the Pratibandhapuram and he became the king of that Pratibandhapuram. But everyone in the kingdom remembered the astrologer's prediction. Many continued to discuss the matter. Slowly it came to the Maharaja's ears. As the king who came to the throne of Pratibandhapuram and started to rule effectively and very efficiently, and almost he forgot what the astrologer predicted before 20 years. Now the people who were surrounded in that region, they did not keep quiet. They often discussed about the prediction, prediction of this king's life, our future. Now, somehow he heard from someone. But everyone in the kingdom remembered the astrologer's prediction. Many continued to discuss the matter. Slowly it came to the Maharaja's ears. There were innumerable forests in the Pratibandhapuram state. They had tigers in them. The Maharaja knew the old saying, you may kill even cow in self-defense. There could certainly be no objection to killing tigers in self-defense. The Maharaja started out on a tiger hunt. As he had interest to kill the tiger, because his death would come from a tiger, as astrologer predicted when he was an infant. Now, the king who kept his vision to kill the tiger, he should remove the tiger from his kingdom, as luckily he had innumerable number of forests in his kingdom. So he did not feel that there would be a shortage of kings in the forest. So the Maharaja decided to kill the tigers on hunting. But initially, the matter of hunting the tiger, it seems to be very easy and it is available nearby. The Maharaja knew the old saying, in order to protect ourselves, we could kill a cow, since cow is considered as holy to the Hindus. But there could be No objection if I kill a tiger in order to protect ourselves. Maharaja decided to kill the tiger as and when he get, because he know the old saying that yes, in order to protect ourselves we can kill the cow. So there would be no matter if he kill the tiger in order to protect himself. The Maharaja was thrilled beyond measure when he killed his first tiger. He sent for the state astrologer and showed him the dead beast. As a brave king, he started hunting the tiger. When he killed the first tiger, he felt overjoyed. He was awestruck and mesmerized because he fulfilled the first target, that he killed the first tiger, and he sent notice to the astrologer and showed him the first tiger. But the astrologer, who said him calmly that king could kill 99 such tiger in the same way, but he must be careful while dealing with the 100th one. Now the king did not get discouraged about the words of this astrologer. Even he decided to kill 100 tigers which comes in his life. Your Majesty may kill 99 tigers in exactly the same manner. But the astrologer drawled, "But what? Speak without fear. What if the 100th tiger were also killed? Then I will tear up all my books on astrology, set fire to them, and I shall cut off my tuft, crop my hair short, and become an insurance agent." The astrologer finished on an incoherent note. Further, the tiger king, who questioned the astrologer that what happened to him if he killed the 100th tiger. Now the astrologer told him that he would tear off all his book on astrology, and he set them fire. Moreover, he gave assurance that he would change his profession from astrologer to insurance agent, and he cropped his hair. He said in an incoherent note, that means in an unclear way. From that day onwards, it was celebration time for all the tigers inhabiting in the Pratibandha Puram. After the killing of the first tiger, the king felt overjoyed because he met the first tiger and he successfully killed it. Now he issued an order that killing of tiger must be banned for other common people except the tiger king. The tiger king could kill the tiger as and when he required, but other people, they were banned to kill the tiger. So it was the celebration time for the tigers which lives in the forest of Pratibandha Puram. The state banned tiger hunting by anyone except the Maharaja. A proclamation was issued to the effect that if anyone dared to fling so much as stone at a tiger, all his wealth and property would be confiscated. He issued a public declaration, proclamation, that if anyone tried to kill the tiger, or if anyone tried to throw a stone to the tiger, they must be punished. Along with that, their property and wealth must be confiscated, taken into the king's custody. The Maharaja vowed he would attend to all other matters only after killing the 100 tigers. Initially, king seemed well set to realize his ambition. Now, the king of Pratibandha Puram, he took a challenge. "I would attend all the matters of court or the kingdom only after killing the 100 tigers. Until then, I would not deal any subject matter in my kingdom." Note that he faced no dangers. There were times when the bullet missed its mark, the tiger leaped upon him, and he fought the beast with his bare hands each time it was Maharaja who won. Yes, in the expedition of hunting the tiger, it was really risky. But when he was going on for hunting, sometimes his bullet missed. But the tiger attacked him, jumped over him, but he successfully killed the tiger in his bare hand. That shows that how bravery he was, how courageous he was, one can understand from this lesson. Another time, he was in danger of losing his throne. A high-ranking British officer visited Pratibandapuram. He was very fond of hunting tigers and fond of being photographed with the tigers he had shot. As usual, he wished to hunt tigers in Pratibandapuram. But the Maharaja was firm in his resolve. He refused permission. "I can organize any other hunt. You may go on boar hunt. You may conduct a mouse hunt. We are ready for a mosquito hunt. But tiger hunt, that is impossible." At right now, as he was leading his life by hunting, by fulfilling his vision in an eccentric way, one day he got the bad news that he was in danger about losing his throne. One day he got a message from the secretary of a British crown prince that he needed to kill tiger and photographed with it. But as the king who banned tiger hunting in his kingdom except the Maharaja, he did not give permission to the English officer to hunt in his kingdom. So he expected somewhat danger from the British officers to lead or to continue in his throne in further days. The British officer's secretary sent word to the Maharaja through the Diwan that the Durai himself did not have to kill the tiger. The Maharaja could do the actual killing. What was important to the Durai was a photograph of himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. But the Maharaja would not agree even to this proposal. If he relented now, what would he do if other British officers turned up for tiger hunt? Further, an officer's secretary who sent a message to the king that, of course, our British officer who did not want to kill the tiger, let the king kill the tiger, but he wanted to take the photograph with the dead tiger. Carcass means dead animal. Even to this also, he did not agree, because it is a matter of question. If same thing asked by the other Britishers, what he could be done? So that's what he did not permit the British officer to take the photograph, the killed animal from the king, because he prevented a British official from fulfilling his desire. The Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom itself. Now the king was very alert, because he expected somewhat danger from the British, as he did not give permission to hunt tiger in the kingdom for British. Now he should protect his king as well as his crown from the external danger. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberation over this issue. As a result, a telegram was dispatched forthwith to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta, send samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs. In the lesson, we heard the term Durai. Durai in Tamil language means chief or leader. As the Pratibandapuram, it is located in the Kanyakumari district of Tamil Nadu. Now, the king and his Diwan, they made some deliberation. In order to protect, in order to save their kingdom, they should do somewhat ideas, somewhat plan. According to their plan, they requested the British company of jewelers in Calcutta that they asked them send some sample of expensive diamond jewel rings. so that he could send them. Nearly 50 rings he could send to the British officer. It worth 3 lakhs of rupees. So after accepting the 50 rings, the British lady, he did not try to seize the kingdom from the king of Pratibandhapuram. In 2 days, a bill for 3 lakh of rupees came from the British jewelers. The Maharaja was happy that though he had lost 3 lakh of rupees, he had managed to retain his kingdom. The king was very happy. Though he had lost 3 lakh rupees, but he successfully retained his kingdom forever when he was ruling his kingdom. Well, students, in today's class, we have learned about the king of Pratibandhapuram partly, how he turned to be the Tiger King and what made him to take a challenge according to the prediction we partly discussed. This lesson is divided into 5 parts. So today's class we have discussed 1st, 2nd and 3rd part. 4th and 5th part will be continued in the next class. Thank you.